Hello all, this is this video showing you how to use analog inputs on your measuring board. Okay, first let's start again with our Simulink start program. Also connect something on, what is it, K8 or K7. In this case I took K8, but it could also have been over here, and a resistor on the upper part so that I have a voltage divider created. After you've done that, we go to Simulink and again to our library, PC Launchpad library, and to read a value, voltage value, we take in this case analog read, so not the ADC converter that you've used earlier, but analog read pin, and it asks for a number, and the number you can find in this document, menu measuring PCB connections and Simulink, and in this case I want to measure the voltage that is present on K7 or K8, which is parallel, so I enter pin 29 in this case, so 29, so it will measure that voltage. I add a display, and connect it to it, and just to be sure also add a scope, so you can read them both. So that's it. You have to build and run it. And when it's running, you will notice that, oh, there you have the values. If you don't see any values over here, I'll also open the scope in this case. Come. And there you see some floating values. If you don't see any values in here, then stop the simulation. Open external motor control panel, enter signal and triggering, again, signal and triggering over here, and say here select all, otherwise you won't see any information. So if you now connect, and start the real-time code again, and you see that it's, well, flickering a bit. You can see it here also. Well, I have now some light on my LDR. When I put my hand over it, you see that the value over there is going up. When I release it again, it's going down, going up. I put my hand over it again and remove it again, and that just out, and see here what it has done for all of our values. Well, you can see that it switched between somewhere around 600 and 2700. So that's the way to read analog values, voltage values, and you can use the same principle for measuring sound. And for sound, you have to take the microphone output, which is pin number 27. Okay, thank you. Until next time.